Today we would understand one of the very important topics in psychology that talks about concept attainment. Now when we talk about concept attainment, it is highly related to thinking. So when you are thinking, you are working towards solving a problem. There are group of objects that are being involved, and based on the group of objects or the categories that you are trying to involve, you are trying to have a kind of mental process. Definitely this formation of concept is a slow process, be it a kind of simple concept or a kind of complex concept that is being formed. This process is ultimately slow, and we say these are the building blocks for formation of thoughts. So that's the basic idea about understanding a concept. Now let's say if I see a child, or a child has a toy, and I give a comment, it's a red toy box. Now the child can relate all the three terms to that toy that he has. Now in the next instance, I have an apple and I tell the child this is a red apple. So this time the child is trying to relate between the two things, understanding that this toy is red in color, this apple is red in color. So color is something that is being talked about, which is abstract and which is common for these two things. And that's how we understand the formation of concept. Now this concept has basically three elements that we talk about. So we have the examples, attributes, and the value of those attributes. Examples can be positive and negative, one which support the concept formation and other which take you away from the concept formation. So let's say I am having a card here and I have a concept in mind, which is the sum on the card would be 10. Now this concept is known to me. The students that are there do not know this concept. Now I'm showing them different cards. One card is with 2 into 5. So the child says something on that and I say yes. That means this is a concept that it's either multiplication or the value of 2 or the value of 5 or 10. Something is there, that's my concept. Similarly, I again show another card with 12 minus 2 and I again say yes. That means both the cards have a common answer 10, and therefore we can say that 10 is a concept that is being formed here. So we are having positive and negative instances. We have the attributes. Some of the attributes are important, some are essential and some are non-essential, which basically talk about the features of the object. And finally, we have the values that are attached to each attribute. Now the Bruner's experiment that we would be talking about today for the concept attainment model considers four features and three values for each feature. So that's really interesting. So we have the four features, which are border. Now there could be one border, there could be two borders, or there could be three borders, as you can see in the diagram. We can have the shape as circle, cross or square. We can have the color as red, green or black. And we can have the number of objects as one object, two objects and three objects that are there. So we have four features that we are taking into account. So these are attribute features and these are the attribute values. So every time you understand the concept, you have these three elements that you try to understand: the example, the attribute feature and the attribute value attached to it. Now based on this, we can have three types of concepts that are talked about. The first is conjunctive concept. Conjunctive concept means we are trying to include all or kind of joint presence of the various variables. So let's say red circle. So I'm talking about the color red and I'm talking about the shape circle and I'm taking them together. In the disjunctive concept, I am talking about the presence of some attribute and the absence of some other attribute. There can be either red color or a circle. So I am talking about the presence of either and the absence of either. So that's disjunctive. And relational is when you have one attribute that is having some kind of relationship with the other attribute that you are talking about. So based on this, what Bruner did was a kind of interesting study. He talked about each feature with three values. So you have feature one with three values. So how many possible combinations could be there? So each feature with three values, so total numbers would be 81. So he presented these 81 cards. Now the cards are 81 But based on these 81 cards, there are different hypotheses that could be propounded. Now, there could be a hypothesis which simply says red. So, it's just the color red that I'm trying to say here. And I'm not trying to explain anything else. So, my number of hypotheses in that case becomes 4. So, it would be 4 into 4 into 4 into 4. And then you are trying to have at least one concept in your mind. And that cannot be a kind of blank card that is there. So, I subtract 1. So, total how many hypotheses I can propound is 255 hypotheses. So, there were 81 cards that Bruner took into account to give 255 hypotheses. Now, what is this exactly concept attainment about? When we talk about concept attainment, let's say I am a researcher here and I have the subjects there. There could be two ways of going around. First is, I know the concept. I am trying the student to inquire about it. So, the student is selecting. The student is showing me, I am telling yes or no. Based on that, the student would select the next choice, which card he should pick up, and he has to find out what concept is there in my mind. So that is what is the selection procedure. This selection procedure involves 4 different strategies. Those are 2 from scanning and 2 from focusing, which we would study in a while. The next method is reception. Reception says, I know my concept and I tell myself whether this is a correct concept or not. And that is what is a reception concept or a reception technique for concept attainment. Under reception technique, we have 2 ways. One is the holist approach, the other is the partist approach. When I say holist approach, this holist approach is similar to what is focusing. So, when we would understand focusing, you would have this idea much more clear. But for now, we can say you have got any positive instance with you. So, with that positive instance, you made a hypothesis. Now, what you are trying to do out of it is you would compare all the attributes to that positive instance and ignore the negative ones. So that would give you a kind of focusing approach. We are focusing on one particular thing and ignoring those which does not match that criteria. So that is holist approach. The other one is the partist approach. So partist approach is similar to scanning. Here you are basically having the choice of the hypothesis which is based on the initial example that I am trying to give you. So those are the 2 approaches under reception. So reception is when I am having a concept with me and I am saying yes or no on that concept. On the other hand, in the case of, I am already labeling it as yes or no. On the other hand, in the selection approach under concept attainment, what we have is, I have a concept with me. The subject would show me different cards. And from those cards, I would say, this card is okay, this card is not okay. So, student is inquiring whether this card is okay or not. And based on the okays and the non-okays that I say, the student will form the concept and find the concept that I have in my mind. So, that is the sole idea of concept attainment. Now, moving forward, we have 4 different strategies that we talk about under the selection procedure of concept attainment. So, under this selection procedure, what we understand are 4 different categories. 2 are the scanning categories and 2 are the focusing categories. So, focusing are similar to the holist approach of reception and scanning are similar to the partist approach of reception. So, under the selection approach, we have the scanning and focusing. Let's first talk about the scanning. Under scanning, we'll start with simultaneous scanning. So, what happens is, I have a concept in my mind and let's say that concept is red circle. Now, what would happen is, we have already seen all the possible combinations that are there. So, the student has to remember all the 255 hypotheses that are there. Now, the student would start showing me the cards. When the student is showing me the cards, I would say yes or no. So, in case, since my concept is red circle, the student would show me a kind of green circle with a border. So, I would say okay. In the other case, he would show me a green cross and I would say not okay. So, he has to remember each and each card that he is showing to me. Based on that, the different hypothesis he is trying to eliminate. So what happens under successive scanning is you are trying to eliminate the incorrect ones, and you are left with very few correct choices from which you would pick out the correct ones. Now towards the end, what would happen is the student would show me red circle, I would say yes. In the other instance, he would show me red square and I would say no. So that makes it very sure that square is not the option. So the only option could be red circle. Now among the red circle also, there could be an option that my concept is red only. So what would happen if my concept is red only? When the person would show me red circle, I would say yes. When he would show me red square, I would say yes. That means square or circle is not important. What is important here is the red color. And that's how we understand the simultaneous scanning. A good way to understand here is I have the instances that are being here, that's red only, and my concept, if it is red only, that could, in that case, I would eliminate the circle. I would eliminate the red circle. However, if my concept is circle only, I would eliminate the red color. And if my concept is red circle, I would eliminate the red out of it. So that's how we are talking about the instance, and based on the instance you are talking about the concept formation which you have to include and which you have to eliminate. So again, I repeat a very simple way. If my concept is red color, just red color, nothing else, the student shows me red circle, I say yes. The student shows me red square, I say yes. That makes it sure for the student that the shape is immaterial, be it circle or square, but red is taken into account. So the concept here is red. Now the only issue with the simultaneous scanning is you have to have a kind of lot of memory that's going into, because you have to keep into mind all the 255 hypotheses at a go, and then you have to eliminate those. So it requires excessive brain work. Then there are also cases where you are trying to have better reasoning that's required. So one of the important conditions for simultaneous scanning is the subject should be intelligent and rational. Based on that, he would show me the next card. However, the next method is a kind of mere guessing, where we say it's successive scanning. So let's say my concept is again red circle. Now, when you are showing me the cards, the card that shows green, I ignore that. Now, what you are trying to do is you are trying to introduce only one variable at a time. So you are just introducing green, seeing that I am doing well with green or not, and I am ignoring green or not. Then you would introduce border. Then you would introduce shape. So you are moving one by one. Now, when in case you are moving one by one, what would happen is, for example, on my concept is red circle. Now, what would happen here is the red color that you are showing, I would say yes. And when you are showing circle, I would say yes. So here you would have a confusion as to where it should go. So it should be a red circle. But when you are showing me black circle, I would say yes again, because circle is yes here. So that makes a kind of confusion here. So it's more of a kind of guesswork. It's less efficient, less pronounced than the simultaneous scanning. However, in this case, what is the major thing here is less thinking is required and less memory is required, because there you were trying to remember all the 255 instances at a go. However, here you are introducing it one by one and you are ignoring which are not, or you are eliminating which are not correct. So in other words, I can say the arrangement of the cards could vary. In one case, you can depict all the cards together. In one case, you can arrange the cards one over the another like a pile, and then you can take out the cards. So based on that, again, you have the limitations that we understand for the successive scanning and the simultaneous scanning that takes place. The next important thing here is the conservative focusing, a very interesting concept. It is considered as the most efficient among all the four strategies for concept attainment. What happens under conservative focusing? let's say my focus card here is three red circles and two borders. So I have a focus card which is three red circles and two borders. Now what I have the concept in my mind is a concept which is red circle. Now what would happen is all the things which relate to it would be given a kind of positive instance, and those which are not related to it would be given a negative instance. So let's say first we talk about green. So let's say I introduce another color. So if there is another color that's introduced, I would say no. So that means color becomes important here. So if I am saying green and I am rejecting it, then I won't show any other green cards. Then what I would bring is, I would change the number of borders. If I bring in one border or zero border or three borders, let's say, so what would happen if I say no, I would eliminate all the cards which have either three borders or one border. So what I am trying to do is, I am trying to change one thing at a time and see the result that is taking place. So three red circles with two borders, that's my idea here. Now what I am changing in the first go is the color. In the second go, I am changing the border and I am saying whether the response is negative or positive. In the third go, I am changing the shape. So from circle, I am moving to a cross. And finally, in the last instance, I am saying three red with a circle and one border is positive. That shows that my, and I say yes onto that card, that shows my concept is correct, because border is not important here. What is important was red circle. Since red circle is my concept, it's immaterial as to the number of the circles. So you have red and circle both going well here, and therefore we say this is a positive instance and you can have a focus, conservative focusing in this case. So conservative focusing, in simple terms, you show the card, keep this as a focus. Whatever negative instances are coming, you try to remove those. So if there is green color, you remove it. If it is a rather than circle, if it is a square, you remove it. Since my concept is only red circle, I would focus on only red and circle. So whatever instance would have red and circle, I would mark those as positive. So this would be positive and this would be positive, irrespective of the border in this case. But if I say my instance is red circle with two borders, then I would consider only this as correct and this would become incorrect. So based on my concept, I would say which of the following cards that the student is showing me would be correct and which would be incorrect. This is much more efficient than simultaneous scanning. It is considered much better. It requires less thinking, less time, more efficient. But the only disadvantage here is whether the instances available on demand or not. So that's how we talk about presentation, whether all the cards are present at a go, so I can just have a look on all of those, or they are piled up onto one another, so I have to just open one after the other and see what happens. So that's one of the major disadvantages. The last important strategy for concept attainment is focus gambling. Let's take the same example. Now, what is the difference between conservative focusing and focus gambling is, here I am changing one feature at a time. In conservative, in focus gambling, I can change multiple features at a given time. So let's say in the same case, what I do is, I change the color, I change the shape, and my concept here was just three figures. So I change all of those, but three remains the same here. So three figures would be there. It could be circle, it could be square, it could be cross, but the number would be 1, 2, and 3. So in that case, just in the first go, my answer was correct. So if I have a card that is being shown to me, which has three green crosses with one border, and I say yes onto it, when my focus card was three red circles with two borders, that means what is not matching? The color is not matching, the shape is not matching, the number of borders are not matching. The only thing that is matching is the number of objects. Since the number of objects are matching, then I can directly say this is my concept and this was a very quick attainment of the correct answer. However, so that is a focus gambling. So if you are getting bigger rewards, Then you can go for focus gambling, because if you are lucky, you would go into just one trial and get a correct response. However, there could be an instance where you could have numerous incorrect responses and still you cannot find out the correct answer. So let's say again, three red circles with two borders is the focus card that is being shown to me. Now what I do is I change the number of circles, I change the greens, I change the shape, and I change the border, and I say this is not the correct one. In the next case, I make it two black circles with cross and no border, and I again say this is not the case. If my concept is red and I am showing this card, then again I would show this is not correct. But if my concept was three figures, as was in the previous case, this chance would turn out to be true because I have three here. But if it was the red as a concept, then I would move on till I have red here, and once I have red here, I would say okay, this is the correct concept that is formed. And it can involve multiple series or a multiple sequence that is there, and therefore if you are unlucky, you would have to have multiple trials. The only thing you have to see is even after multiple trials, you are not running into a huge loss, and that's why we call it a focus gambling. So that's what is the four important strategies for concept attainment given by Bruner. We would be talking about more interesting topics in psychology in the upcoming classes. So stay tuned. Have a great day ahead.